Live from the Auburn Pitt Studios at PFG Television Center, this is Scorch's PFG TV, presented by the New England Subaru Dealers. My name is Jessica. Tonight on the show, joining Scorch is snowcross performer Jake DeSilva. Plus, we'll debut the appetizer. Our friends from Mayhem Inc. will be in to discuss their Ink for Pink event. Of course, we'll have weird news. And the man on the couch, Nick Carpinelli. And continuing our Future of Music series is Amanda McCarthy. Now, the man who remembered my birthday this week. Aww, here's Scorch.
Hey, welcome to Scorch's PFG TV. Listen to this one. Oh, I love it. Keep it going. I love it. Can you see my desk is rising?
I see that. Stop.
See that? For those that were wondering what's going on, you just made my desk rise, and that's amazing. Good for you guys. Hey, welcome to another fine episode of Scorch's PFG TV. But wait a sec. I will take the applause, but we have now, with this show here, we have expanded the Scorch's PFG TV network. We are back in New York, baby! Oh, yeah! Oh, my God. It's so exciting.
You know what's cool is we've got our own affiliate.
We've got affiliates
awesome.
Now, yeah. We as of this show went up into the from the low millions of homes to the upper millions, like near 10 million homes. Scorch's PFG TV is now ingratiating on your set. So thank you very much for being part of this. Holy smokes! Y'all know Nick Carpinelli, right? Give it up for Nick. Once again, we say, mind you, and I'm going to go through the whole thing very quickly. We say, my, how far we've come, because literally it was 3 years ago, I believe, this week.
Yep.
It was 3 years ago, March the 3rd was the day that we did our very first internet-only show with handheld cameras and really sucky mics. And, you know,
Shower curtain
for the backdrop. Yep, we had a real legitimate shower curtain. And now, 3 years later, just over a year on network TV, and the network expands into almost 10 million homes. So you know what? Thank you guys for being part of this.
And may I say, F you to all the naysayers. You said it wouldn't go anywhere.
Right? Yeah, you know, you really don't want to be like that. I won't mention any names. No, but we did go through a bunch of people that were like, yeah, this show is really not going to do anything. Well, you know what? Those that said that, it's funny, but in their lives, you know what they're doing? Nothing. And what are we doing? We're multiplying by millions upon millions of homes every week. And this is just really the beginning, because we are truly going to be going into into the Texas market in just a couple of months. And we're also going to be on, as far as if things keep going right, we're going to be on in Gainesville, Florida, which is where the University of Florida is.
Yes,
and we're going to be on there before school starts in 2011. So lots of good things happening. So. Yeah, and we have a busy show today, so let's get into it with the segment that we call Weird News. The first story today, out of New Orleans, Louisiana, 38-year-old Cotina Holmes. Remember when you dated a chick named Cotina?
Yeah.
Cotina Holmes was arrested and booked for aggravated assault. It seems she was having an argument with a teenager. And when he got on his school bus, she followed him, threatening him with a gun. She then said, go ahead and call the cops. They won't do anything. How could she be so sure? She's a cop. Yeah, but at least she was, because this case is now under investigation. Good for them. I love our weird news stories, because they get dumber and dumber every time. Police in Gainesville, Florida... Had to have a Florida story.
Always do.
Only a two-name person, though. Police in Gainesville, Florida, recently arrested 48-year-old Deborah Oberlin after she failed a sobriety test. I won't even get into that one now. When police asked what she was doing, she said she just came from a party and she had to pick up her daughter from a school dance after her daughter complained that she just got through smoking some bad crack. Yeah, that in itself is dumb but not ironic. The ironic part of the story is that Ms. Oberlin's last job, mind you, she got stopped for drunk driving. She was the head of the local chapter of MAD, Mothers Against Drunk Driving. In this case, MAD stood for Mother and Daughter dumb. That's about that. And finally today, police in Indianapolis, Indiana. Do you realize Indianapolis is still, after all these years, in Indiana?
I had no idea.
I was shocked. I had to look it up. I looked it up. I looked it up on the PFG TV app, which I'll tell you about soon. Police in Indianapolis, Indiana have arrested father and son potty mouths, Andrew and Stephen Quinn, after their neighbors complained they turned up their sound system and continuously yelled curse words and profanity so the whole block can hear them. That's why people watch this show quietly, because we can get, after the whole Millie incident, you never know what'll happen. When police arrived, they heard the duo calling the lady next door some very colorful names. And this is true. The funniest part of this whole story was the Quinn's address. They lived at, ready for this? 4Q. And that, my friends, is today's installment of Weird News. Okay, we have a whole busy show in store, so why don't we continue things, and we will get into our very first sponsor break. Give it up for our sponsor break. Hey, I like that. I mean, after all, how could you not want to give a nice round of applause to the New England Subaru dealers, you know what I mean? We wouldn't have this show without the New England Subaru dealers. Let me tell you about the New England Subaru dealers and their Impreza. I think Impreza is PFG Nice for impressive. You know what I mean?
Oh, I'm sorry, PFG Nice?
Well, what the hell? What am I going to say?
You know okay, I don't know.
It's PFG Nice. Is that better?
Genese.
PFG Nice.
There you go. All right.
For impressive. And Subaru just in any language means great freaking car. Plus, you're going to love the safety of a Subaru. You realize the safety and the brand new Subaru Impreza, all-wheel drive, it's symmetrical. Remember, they have that boxer engine, which is nice. It's not a tidy-whitey engine. No, they wouldn't do that. It's a boxer engine, you know. I mean, they let their junk hang out in their engines, you know. Love the safety. Love the price. You can get a brand-new Subaru Impreza, well-equipped, for $17,495. That's nothing, really. Remember, like, when you were a kid and Mr. Softy, the ice cream man, came down the street, and the ice cream man had one of them little change things on the side of his belt buckle.
Yep.
You have that in your change thing right now as a radio and TV host, Nick. You know what I mean? By the way, we'll go back to our sponsors in a second. Can you get a shot of this one right here? As we mentioned, the radio show, Rock 101, rock101fm.com. Check it out. Jessica, middays, commercial-free, 10 to noon. Me, afternoons, 2 to 7, nothing but commercials. Nick, overnights, very few commercials and a lot of fun, so check it out. And check out your local Subaru dealers at newenglandsubaru.com. Subaru, it's safe for the whole family, and love is what makes a Subaru, give it up. Auburn Pitts, you realize earlier tonight, it was last night, we had the Nothing Ventured, Nothing Gained a variety show, whatever the hell we called it. I don't remember. That was last night already. Nothing for Nothing variety show. And what a great time. Packed house at Auburn Pitts. Next thing up for them, St. Patrick's Day. Now, I talked to Carmen today. You have never had Italian corned beef and cabbage till you've had it at Auburn Pitts. And they are going to give you the biggest Reuben sandwiches you have ever seen. The band American Mixer is going to be there. St. Patrick's Day, just another fun-filled, packed day at Auburn Pitts, 167 Rockingham Road. Now, our next sponsor, this is one of our newest family members, and I'm not giving him any more shtick than I normally do because he's actually standing in the crowd tonight. He wanted to see the show, but he emailed me today and says, oh my God. I believe the quote was, Scorch, you're the effing man. So I appreciate that. You know what? And they're an effing cool, and I don't even know what that means. They're a very cool swimming pool company. That's why they are the official swimming pool company of Scorch's PFG TV. Give it up for Daigle Servicing Company. Remember, Daigle Servicing Company. I love one of the best things they can do. You know what? This really is still nothing worse than a spring or a summer cold. But you know what? You're having relatives to the house. You're having friends for a barbecue. You're laying in bed. I feel like crap. I sound like Scorch. I sound like I smoked 20 packs a day. And I got to have a party this week. Except for the fact hot chicks are coming. That sucks. What am I going to do? Daigle Servicing Company. They bring the pool store to you. Do you realize that? And you know what? Give Don like a big enough tip. He'll clean your pool for you. You know what? He'll sit there with the tissue. It'll be like a nice daddy. Bro, you know, that's part of the service they give you at Daigle Servicing Company. You know what I mean? Now, the new store is opening up in just a couple of days. Check out their website, DaigleServicingCo.com. Check them out on the PFG TV website. Check them out on the app. And you're going to be hearing a lot more about them, including Nick's idea. Everybody, I'm giving him credit. Nick's idea.
Oh, my
okay?
God. Mark, okay.
The Daigle Servicing Company Pool Tool of the Week is coming up real soon. So, Daigle Servicing Company, thank you for being part of the show. And you know who else we want to thank very quickly, even though this is not their week, I will give them the love, localadprone.com. That's our pal Howie Snyder and crew. By the time this show airs, we're actually revamping the PFG phone app, which is what Local Ad Pro NE did. And we're going to be giving you daily updates and daily alerts. And the app, we're going to add a couple of new segments. The restaurant roll call segment is now actually a specific segment on the app. I've got a PFG fun and games section on the app now where you can play games like Who's the Biggest Hoe in Hollywood and stuff like that. So it's all thanks to Local Ad Pro NE. So give it up for all of our sponsors so far. Wow. If your timing was a girl's time of the month, she would have been pregnant. Let's try that again. Give it up for our sponsors right now.
Interesting analogy there.
Thank you very much. Hey, Jessica, by the way, happy birthday earlier this week, Jessica. We love you. Tell us what's coming up, and we'll be back with more of Scorch's PFG TV.
Coming up, we'll talk to the people doing the Ink for Pink event. Also, a bit later on, it's the debut of the appetizer. Now, here's our first pub crawl on Scorch's PFG TV.
TV. We're going to tell you how you can get on the pub crawl and how your business can be part of the show in just a little bit. Right now, though, these guys here and the guys and girls, they have a really good event coming up in about a week and a half or so. Actually, I believe it's a week from tomorrow. And it's for a sucky cause that's a great cause. You know what I mean? The cause itself, it sucks that there is a cause like this. But you know what? They're doing such a good thing. And I want to get it right. I believe John is calling Get Some Ink and Make It Pink. This is the guys and girls from Mayhem Ink. And we're going to be talking about the breast cancer thing coming out. Wow. So good for you, John. John, by the way, John here, and it's not to plug his place again, because I will give him some more love soon, but John has been at the sponsor end of the TV show from the very beginning. Mayhem Inc. is the name of his shop. It's on Broad Street, Nashua. We'll talk more about that soon, but good for you for doing what you're doing with this event. You know what I mean? I think it's great. You know, and so explain the whole thing. Explain what the event is and what it's called, and then we'll get into some of the more specifics of it.
It's just a benefit to for the girls for their raise money for their walk, and they can probably explain it better. But all we do is we just give the place to them and tattoo pink ribbons or whatever anybody wants for the whole day. And
it's amazing that there are times that you may, a lot of people probably would not even think, huh, I want to get a pink ribbon tattoo. But then you do an event like this.
Oh, you'd be surprised.
Yeah, and you do an event like this, and they come out in droves, and you know what I mean? And so, yeah, you know, that's a good thing. So, now the event is the 13th, right? It's Sunday.
Right, Sunday the 13th.
Yeah, so it's a week from tomorrow, okay.
Right.
And if you want to pass the mic along, that's sure. Cool. Why don't you girls introduce yourselves and for the world to see and tell us, like, tell us what's going on with this event and about your walk.
Hi, I'm Marianne Cahoon, and I have the honor to be captain of this team. There's 27 of us. We walk 39.3 miles for breast cancer, and I'm going to pass because I could go on and on. That's why I'm captain.
Can I just say, for those that are now watching in New York, that I'll translate, that's breast cancer. Okay.
Well, yes, you know. And we walk.
And we walk. Yes, exactly. Yeah, go pass along. Let's hear who else you got with you.
Good evening. I'm Patricia Frizzetti, and I started this fundraiser 2 years ago. It really started 4 years ago when I was first diagnosed with breast cancer. And we all know that every 3 minutes somebody is diagnosed, and every 14 minutes somebody actually dies from this awful disease. But it really doesn't hit home until it happens personally to you. And it was devastating. And it was a long journey of doctors and tests you go through and weekly trips into Boston. But
you can never give up. You can never give up hope.
No, I knew going through it that I wanted to give back because you changed from it. And I wanted to give back to other women out there the hope and the encouragement. And that came along with John stepping up financially to help with this fundraiser. And go from there.
Hi, I'm Deb Moore, and Trish is my best friend. And when she was diagnosed a few years ago, really her battle became my battle.
Yeah.
And we walked through much of it together, and the past 2 years I've been at the finish line waiting for her to cross with her awesome team. But this year I'm actually walking
good
it this year.
So now what kind of a special training? I mean, do you girls all walk a lot on a daily basis? Do you exercise a lot? Because you all look smoking hot. I mean, so I'm just wondering, is this something, are you training specifically for this?
You do have to train to walk the 39.3 miles. It's 26.2 the first day and 13.1 the second
day. You don't wear those
boots,
do you?
No, you don't. You wear good sneakers, and you have to train. So we train as a team. Our team's pretty big, so it's difficult to get everybody all at once. But you do what you can, you know.
Do you have to eat stuff, like eat certain foods? Like, I know the Boston Marathon runners, like the day before. No, the marathon runners, the day before, they carb up on pasta dinners and stuff. Is this something?
We eat pizza.
We eat pizza.
And you have to carbs from beer, you know.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, well, good for you. Good for you. And so where is this walk taking place? Tell us about the walk this year.
It starts in Boston at UMass in Boston, and it's actually started at the same place. I've been doing it for 4 years. This is my fourth year walking.
Oh, good for you. Yes, no doubt. Good for you.
It starts at UMass Boston. It goes to the Reebok Center. Reebok's a big sponsor for this walk, along with Genentech and a couple others. You can go online at avonwalk.org, and you can look up some more information on it. And our team, Charlie's Angels, was the number one team last year. Raising $78,000, which was pretty amazing.
And, you know, it does. Like I said earlier, it sucks that there has to be events. Because it sucks that there's the disease, and it sucks there has to be events like this, you know, and that's a weird thing to say. It's a great thing that there are events like this, but you know what I mean? It sucks that you even have to worry about having to do this, you know what I mean? It sucks that, like, you know, that people have this crap going on in their lives. It's true. I bet you there's not one person watching or in the audience right now that doesn't at least know of somebody, a family member, a friend's family, somebody that hasn't been affected by the disease, you know what I mean? And it's just insane, you know. Now, what other things, and I don't want to downplay the walk, because we'll get back to that in a second. What other things do you ladies do and guys do during the year? other than this walk? What other kind of events do you do?
Fundraise.
Sure, yeah.
We stopped the walk in May, and then next week we had a fundraiser for this year, because these ladies want to raise $100,000 this year.
And you know what? You have to. There really is. There's no such thing as, that's enough, right? I mean, there's never going to be enough as such thing as that. Yeah, we did it. That's enough. You're gonna keep going and going and going, huh?
And 2 years ago, the team was a different name, but there was 26 women, and they turned around. They said, "No, we're going to be Charlie's Angels." So they voted on it. And the other fellow I walked with, we were in Massachusetts. He says, "I feel like a Republican in Massachusetts. I don't have a vote."
Now, you know, I don't know about anybody else in the audience, but every guy should envy this man right here. This guy here is walking with thousands of women on a team. You know what I mean? Good for you.
This is my fifth year walking.
Oh, you are Charlie of Charlie's Angels.
Charlie.
Wow. I'm so used to seeing you on a little box on a TV, so you know, say, "Are there angels?" But I actually never seen you. You know what? You're better looking in person than you sound on that little box. You know what I mean? I hear that every day, too. So the event is the 13th at Mayhem Inc., and it's on Broad Street in Nashua at TattooMayhem.com, AvonWalk.org. You know what? Give it up for these guys and girls right here, because what a beautiful thing. We're going to help you guys out as much as we can, so hang tight for a couple of seconds. Very quickly, what I want to do right now is I want to do a debut of a brand new thing on the show. We're going to call this the Scorch's PFG TV appetizer, yeah! Because now, Scorch's PFG TV is now on a phone app that has been, so far, in just over a month, we have been downloaded almost 250,000 times. I think that's just insane. Yeah. Now, on the app, you have got Scorch's PFG TV, the latest episodes. You've got the archive of the episodes, all in high def, all on your phone, you know what I mean? Or your iPad, for that matter. You've got a fun and games section. You've got sponsor information. So let's talk about Daigle again for a second. Daigle Servicing Company. You're hanging out. You're like, wow, I knew there was a pool company. It began with a D. You go onto the app, or actually the website too, but we're talking about the app now. Go onto the app. You hit his thing. It's going to go right. You hit his icon, if you will. It's going to go right to his page, tell you all his information. So, sponsor stuff. The restaurant roll call. We want restaurants right at your fingertips. You're hanging out watching the show. We're always talking about getting baked, so you get hungry. You get the munchies. You're like, what can I eat? Ah, I go to the restaurant roll call. Boosh. You hit one of your favorite restaurants. For this one, I'll say Louie Louie on Daniel Webster Highway in Nashua, home of the best antipasto on God's green earth. You go there, you hit the thing, you get the menu, you say, wow, I saw this on the app. And that's something else on the app. There's going to be special fun links. There's just a ton of new stuff. Download the app. It's available for Androids, iPhones, iPads, Blackberries, Strawberries, and an occasional Cantaloupe as well. It's under Scorch's PFG TV. And it's absolutely free. I'm always out here whoring out this show for money, and I'm giving you something for absolutely free. So there you go. Speaking of whoring things out, let's do our next sponsor break. This time around, I want to talk about Mayhem Inc. Mayhem Inc. on Broad Street in Nashua. Not just because he's sitting right next to me. But once again, you know what I love about John's place? John, they're having a piercing special right now. Brand new website. The website, he had the same trouble I did before I went to company GWD, and he went to his person. We tried and tried and tried. Yeah, I can get a website done for you. Remember that? Yeah, I can get it done for you. Yeah, 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 blah, blah, blah. Finally, I went to your website the other day. Perfect, beautiful site to let you see all about the shop. The shop itself, they are body modification experts. Plus, they do piercings. They have over a gazillion years combined experience with tattooing. And also, they are the home of Sharp Objects Jewelry, Mayhem Inc., and this event here, this Ink for Pink thing happening a week from tomorrow. So, you know what? Give it up for John and crew of Mayhem Inc. Bonneville Kia. Bonneville Kia. You know what? Bonneville Kia is the area's number one Kia dealer. So you got to give it up for Bonneville Kia, too. The Soul, the Forte, the Optima, the Sorento. You know, if you go to their Facebook page and you like them, you know, back when I was a little boy and I used to watch the Mike Douglas show saying, man, I want to do that when I'm older. I want to do a TV talk show. I never heard of anything. I never heard Mike Douglas say, would you go to Facebook and like my show? You know what I mean? Back then, we used to call radio stations to get a busy signal, to use a party line on a busy signal. Anybody ever remember doing that? Oh, my God. Anyhow, now you go to Facebook. You like the Bonneville Kia page, and somehow leave a message about Scorch's PFG TV, and they're going to just keep going and going and going. Exit 9S off I-93, KiaNH.com. Check out Bonneville Kia. Also, you know who we got to thank? Abscomp, Absolute Computer. Can you get a hold of this thing right here? How can you not get a hold of it? It's the biggest advertisement on the TV show to date. Absolute Computer, they are the official computer supplier of Scorch's PFG TV. They specialize in refurbished units. They can hook you up now with like a refurbished laptop under $450. You can get, actually it's like $199 for the refurbished laptop. You can get a full-fledged a desktop computer. What do you call those? A tower computer, if you will? Excuse me. See, I get so excited, I get filled with phlegm. You know what I mean? Yeah, I love phlegm. By the way, phlegm, it's a fun word. It's fun to say, and it's fun to hear rattling around your lungs. Anyhow, you can get a tower computer with a brand new monitor for $490. So, I mean, Abscomp, Absolute Computer, they do repairs, they do software, they do servicing. We love them. That's why they are the official computer supplier of Scorch's PFG TV. And because we want this show to be on the up and up, we have to thank our accountants, Bobby's Bookkeeping and Tax Service. Bobby'sBusinessServices.com. Check them out. They'll do your taxes. And somehow they'll you know what? They'll write out checks. She does people's books like she does companies' books. She will write out checks for you more than you make. The boss won't even find out, you know what I mean? Your boss, like John's workers, right? If John had Bobby's business become their accountants, John's workers, John writes out checks anyway for $3,000-$4,000 a week because he pays his people well. Bobby's business, I was ready to call it my mom. Go figure that. Bobby's business will give you $8,000 or $9,000 and nobody will even know about it, so check him out. Anyhow, those are our sponsors for round two. Jessica's going to tell us what's coming up, and we have a lot more of Scorch's PFG TV.
Still on the way, Snowcross performer Jake Da Silva and information on how you can get on the show. First, it's time to see where your favorite band is playing. It's the Pub Crawl on Scorch's PFG TV.
Scorch's PFG TV once again, just to make her feel good. Everybody say, happy birthday, Jessica!
Happy birthday, Jessica!
You know what I haven't done in so long? Everybody say, hi, Nick!
Hi, Nick!
Wow, let's go. Let's start doing that again.
It's been a long time, man. Yeah. I feel like I should be making a drink.
That was something we did back in the shower curtain days. Back when I used to peek in with Nick, and I didn't really peek in when he was taking a shower. I would open the curtain, and he'd have an audience full of people going, hi, Nick. Yeah. You know, so.
I am an exhibitionist.
The man has the world's longest website I have ever seen in my life.
Thank you.
But he agreed I can just put it on the screen as .com, and he's going to let you figure out exactly what the rest of it is. One of the best snowcross racers around, and this is a very cool thing. We've never had snowcross racers on the show. His name is Jake DeSilva. Give it up, my friend. That's nice. What's up, man? Nice to have you here. So DeSilvaRacing172.com, and I see you're wearing your little DeSilvaRacing172 shirt. How did the whole snowcross thing come about? How'd you get into that as a fun thing to do?
Well, my dad and uncle had a race team for snowmobiles on drag racing on the ice and grass. And my family owns DeSilva Motorsports in Hampstead, New Hampshire, and Moultonboro, New Hampshire. Oh. And we sell snowmobiles, four-wheelers, things like that.
You do know what's coming up. Right? As they once said, I think it was Sammy Davis Jr., I gotta be me, I gotta be me. You're gonna sponsor the show, right? Or you can get the hell out that door. Right? You know what I mean? Come on. The worst thing you can do is come on this show and say, and my family owns not only one, but two, so you know they're doing good. Yeah, anyhow, we'll talk after the show, trust me. If you want this segment to air, we'll talk after the show. By the way, I sang that really well, didn't I? I thought that was pretty good. Thank you. Me and Sammy are brothers, so it's all good, you know what I mean? Anyhow, tell us more. So did your dad and your parents actually start you? Or what made you go into the snowcross field?
For me to get into snowcross, we actually sponsored a team out of Salem, New Hampshire, who used to race. And the owner of the team always said to my dad and uncle, if I wanted to race, to just have me come. And one weekend, they were racing, and my uncle built me a race sled. And he's like, hey, go try it. If you like it, we'll try it out. And I had a blast, and I've been doing it ever since.
Good for you, no question. Any injuries? Worst injury? Any bad injuries?
Yeah, I've had quite a bit of injuries.
Do tell. We want to know. Everybody that wants to do this for a living right now or have fun with it, what injuries have you had?
I've actually had a brain contusion and a collapsed lung, which was my worst. And I got medevaced to...
See, isn't that cool? Yeah. He got medevaced. Come on.
I've broke stuff both in my legs.
When you were laying in the helicopter, weren't you saying to yourself, man, this is freaking cool?
I wish I...
Yeah, it's just like...
Yeah, man.
Yeah, that's awesome. That's fun. Woo! Helicopter ride.
Remember that day? Remember this, Nick? Yeah, so you know...
So exactly how sick are you getting with these stunts here? I mean, were you backflips and what are you doing?
I don't do backflips or anything. I race there's actually an event this past week in Salem at
Rockingham Park. Yeah,
and they had freestyle there where they do the tricks and everything. But I actually did it's a course setup,
right.
Jumps and everything.
So it's like basically it's like motocross,
exactly,
except with snowboards.
Exactly, motocross.
Yeah, so it's awesome, man. It's like X Games that extreme.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. Hopefully one day I'll get to go to the X Games and everything if everything goes right.
You know, I was once offered a jump. One of my better friends, actually, now they're on in the Cuse in that area. One of my friends from the Syracuse area, Beagle Jarvis, is very big into the X Games and the gravity games and stuff like that. Is snowcross racing as big as like some of the other sports these days, or is it getting there? Like, is it going to be snowcross racing magazines and baseball cards and things, or?
There's not like baseball cards. There's like team posters and like team stat cards or individual stat cards that we hand out to all the fans and stuff. And there already is. There's actually a magazine called Snow Cross Magazine.
My parents are the publishers.
Yeah.
And they publish it in 150 states.
Nah. But there's, like I said, there's already that. And it is definitely growing. Snowcross and motocross is getting, motocross and supercross are getting really, really big. And snowcross is following its footsteps and everything. So
the chicks must love you, right?
Oh yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
So like in the off season, are you doing like the grass drags? Are you like doing the open water stuff? I mean,
In the off season, I don't race as much, but I train in motocross. Mm-hmm. I practice for motocross. I do race a little bit, but
the crosses over though, right? I mean, the experience you gain from motocross helps with snowcross.
Yeah, for sure. That's why I do race motocross in the summer and train and everything, because it relates to so much to everything on a snowmobile, basically. So,
yeah, sure. And plus, your parents get you backed up with the equipment, right?
Yeah, for sure.
Beautiful. So.
At the Silver Racing Company in this place. Is there a ranking system? Is there a champion snowcross racer? And if so, where on this list are you?
Well, the way it goes is there's...
Why? Say, yeah, I'm number one, number two, and number five.
Now, the way it goes, there's different, like, circuits. There's the national tour, and then there's regional circuits. And then it goes, there's pro, there's semi-pro, and then it goes to sport division, and then juniors. So, I mean, there's kids that are racing anywhere from 8 to 10 years old. Like, that's when they start. I race in the semi-pro division at the national level and in the regional level.
Good for you. Nice. Really, no question, huh?
Right now, I am actually contracted to race the regional events for East Coast Snowcross through Skidoo, which is one of my sponsors.
All I hear is cha-ching, cha-ching, cha-ching.
Scorch like Bombardier, eh?
So right now, your parents' company owes me for everything you just plugged. So I figure Scorch's PFG TV will be coming to a TV set near you for the next 30 years, thanks to the Silver Racing. Did you ever get pissed off in a race that somebody's in a race and they kind of like pissed you off, so you cut them off and made them wipe out, and you're like,
No, I've definitely gotten pissed off in a race. And I mean, I've definitely hit my share of people. I've been hit plenty of times too, but I mean, it's all racing.
Why don't you do like snowcross derby, and as you're, you know, doing your thing, biff, you give them a nice crack in the head, foam over the railing, down the mountain.
Well, I don't have Scorch's money from all the sponsors, so
yeah. Okay, we're going to have to talk about that, Junior, right there. That's where this interview ends, right there. So it's DeSilvaRacing172.com. What can people see videos of you and stuff like that?
There's pictures, videos. There's all our sponsors, like you're saying here. And they can look at our results, our schedule, where we'll be racing next, and what's going on.
And don't forget to support their sponsors, because Lord knows he needs money. And by the way, while you're on your page, while you're on Jake's page supporting his sponsors, support me too, okay? Because I deserve it just as much as he does. Yeah. Know what I'm saying? That's right. God bless it. Jake, you're a good man. We'd love to have you back on the show. Come back on some hang time right there. Give it up for Jake DeSilva. Okay, now here's what's going to go on. I want to tell you how you can actually get on the show, how you can be part of the live studio audience for the tapings, and how to become a sponsor. As far as getting on the show, we're actually booked through March and into April. Okay, so we're looking now at April, middle of April onward. We are looking for talents, both musically and non-musically. The gig is, I really want to get some of you New York people involved as well. We've had a few bands on from New York already. We've had Brand New Sin on, and I know we had Augustine on, and we had a Stranger Than Fate on as well, and a Perfect Stranger, Stranger Than Fate, some Stranger Something band out of Syracuse, I'm sorry. So we want other bands like that. Magicians, I'd love to get a magician on, a juggler that can really juggle, somebody that can juggle humans. I want a muscle man that can juggle me and Nick at the same time, you know what I mean? More comedians that can pull submarine sandwiches out from their cleavage, like Stephanie did last week. People that can turn their eyelids inside out. I have a guy coming on that calls himself the human floor. And he actually has hundreds of, he'll have the whole studio audience standing on him on a platform. And he also turns himself into a human dartboard, which I have a surprise coming up for you. You are going to be able to finally throw darts at my face. Put it that way, okay? We'll preface it that way. So,
is it getting a tattoo?
Yep. now to be in the studio audience, get on our guest list. It's simple. Scorch or Nick at pfg-tv.com. The guest list, it's absolutely free. It's a closed set. We start at 7:30. We're done by 8:30, 9 o'clock at the very latest. And you know what? You get to see how a TV show is done. And you get to be part of a studio audience, much like this one here. Sponsors, you know, I got to be honest, and this is the God, this is the truth, so help me. I actually got in touch with Don Daigle about his pizza shop, which I'm going to give it a plug again. Hungry Herbs in Merrimack, New Hampshire. Check him out. He said, why don't we do this? Why don't we go with the pool thing? And now he's realizing that the things we talk about here and everything I say, we joke a lot, but what I say on a weekly basis is the truth. I do, and this show does need your money to keep going. However, we're not just going to take money from people for the sake of surviving. I put my my voice in my face every time we do a sponsor mention. It's me or Nick or whoever, we talk about the sponsors. We're not going to talk about people we don't believe in, because then you're going to go there and the place is going to suck, and you're going to come back to me and say, but you told me a place is great. You know what? That's why I won't do that. If you would like to become a part of the family, believe me, we like to consider everybody that's on the show, from the bands to the people with the rich parents like Jake, to everybody. We consider them family members. I'm going to ask Uncle Jake's dad and Aunt Jake's mom for birthday presents for the past 30 years, so it's all good. But, yeah, so we love to have you on the show. We have sponsor packages starting at next to nothing. We have the pub crawl and the restaurant roll call. You can get your information out $10 a week, you cheap bastards. So invest in yourself and help support the local arts. You know what I mean? I believe, and this is what I've been saying, I believe in the invest, support, and payback system, and it's true. You invest in yourself, okay? You're not just giving us money. You invest in yourself, because everything we do, whether it's the band thing or whether it's the restaurant thing or actual full-fledged sponsors, we plug the living hell out of you. So you invest in yourself. You support the local arts and this TV show, which we need the support. You know what I mean? The best way to put it is we take on a weekly basis the local arts and the local economy, and we turn it into like a national looking network show. Not many places can do that, and I'm not looking for praise, but you know what? We do that, and that's what we're talking about, you know what I mean? So, yeah, you know what I mean? Anyhow, I'm just rambling now, so just go to pfg-tv.com and become part of the family, and we love you for it. Thank you very much. Okay. That was such a touching speech. I don't know where to go now. You know what I mean? Oh, yeah, speaking of family members, Carl and Nivea, our photographer and one of our camera people, both having a little trouble with some family members. Hope all is well with both of you guys, okay? Please. Now, let us do our final. I like effing with Bobby. She's fun. Yeah. Sponsor break! Ah! Pretty good, Bobby. Pretty impressive. I gotta give her credit. Once again, we got to give thanks to New England Subaru Dealers. My friend Chili's favorite car, it's the Outback. Only my private and personal friends know what that means. Love you, Chill. Just like I'd love the safety of a Subaru Outback. It's the best-selling all-wheel drive car in America. It has a powerful boxer engine standard. Another one awarded the top safety pick by the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety. It has a higher predicted resale value than the Toyota Highlander, the Jeep Grand Cherokee, all other midsize utility vehicles as well. $23,495, well-equipped. How do you not love that? You know what I mean? NewEnglandSubaru.com. Safe for the whole family. It is what makes a Subaru a Subaru. Also, once again, give it up for Auburn Pitts. You know what? Do you like Reuben sandwiches? Do you like Reubens?
I do like Reuben sandwiches.
Back absolutely. When I was a corned beef eater and a meat eater, I loved Reuben sandwiches, corned beef and sauerkraut and a little Thousand Island dressing.
Yeah.
Nice little toast on the bread. Well, Carmen is promising for St. Patrick's Day the biggest Reuben sandwiches you have ever seen. And that's at Auburn Pits. Plus, on a regular basis, they have steak dinners. They have seafood dinners. And, of course, the money card. Mention you saw them on Scorch's PFG TV. They will give you a $50 money card for a mere $25.
Yeah.
Get a couple of Stoli limes or Stoli lemons on the rocks into Carmen. He might give them to you for $10. You never know. Auburn Pitts, we love you. Thank you for being part of the show. Now a couple of quick mentions. The official tanning salon of Scorch's PFG TV, Soleil Bronze, tannh.com. You know what? Prom season's coming up. Basically, summertime's coming up. Don't go out there and get fried your first time. Have a little base tan going on. Check out Soleil Bronze at tannh.com. And you know who else we want to thank? I want to thank Flying Phil and Victoria at Company GWD for Scorch's PFG TV's website, PFG-TV.com. And those are our sponsors for the night. We really just got one more thing to do. So, Jessica, tell us what that is, and we're coming back, and we're going to finish out what a great episode of Scorch's PFG TV. Oh, nice crowd. Thank you.
We continue our Future of Music series with Amanda McCarthy in just a few minutes. Now, let's do our final pub crawl on Scorch's PFG TV.
You know, last week we had a band called Closer Than We Appear. They kicked it off. Still coming up, we have a band called the College Fund Band. They're going to close it. Next week, we have the School of Rock doing Frank Zappa. They're going to kind of be the stuff in the middle of it. And this week, we continue with the Scorch's PFG TV's Future of Music series. This young lady is phenomenal. You are going to be hearing so much from her, despite the fact she's playing this show. This is Amanda McCarthy on Scorch's PFG TV.
Bye. There's something called denial, and boy, you know it well. It's tearing me apart inside. I bet you couldn't tell. I watch you as you walked away, wishing you were mine. I told you that I'd tell you when the time was right. I guess I lied. Think about the last we share and all the words you say. I prayed and prayed those feelings would never go away. But now I'm wishing by the now will somehow come alive. So you will never see how much it's killing me inside. I lie to you and I say I'm fine with just friends. Cause I'd rather have you just as that than it's nothing else.
What a show tonight. Now, the best part about the whole thing is the fact that this is our very first show as we expand our network. So once again, welcome to all of you guys from New York, from all of us here. Welcome. Thank you for checking out the show. If, for whatever reason, you might want to check out some previous shows, you can go to the website, pfg-tv.com, or you can download the phone app, which is Scorch's PFG TV. Just look it up. You can do it at any smartphone, the iPhone, the iPad, like I said earlier. And basically, yep. And you can watch the previous shows. And if you happen to miss it on TV, you'll be able to see it every week anyway. So, sponsors from New York, you saw the way we do the sponsor breaks. We need you to become part of the sponsor family as well. So, I'm just going to give a little for example. For example, Casa del Pani on Milton Ave in Solvay in Syracuse. You know what? Thank you so much. I'll be looking for your money, Mike. Also, let's just say All Mixed Up in Cicero. All Mixed Up on Route 11 in Cicero. Luann and Tim, I'm coming looking for your money, too. Don't worry about that. So now, we got to thank all the people. We got to thank Kirk and Nick R. in the booth. We got to thank Ryan in the other booth. I want to thank Bobby out here running one of the cameras. Brian, the floor director. We want to thank Jeanette, who's just an all-around swell girl with the family. And you know what? Today's show, she's swell. Today's show was incredible. Due in part to Jake DeSilva. AvonWalk.org. Support it. Give as much money as you can. Give it up for the Charlie's Angels crew in Miami. And I told you she's going to be good. She's going to be amazing. You're going to be hearing so much from her. It's Amanda McCarthy. Next week, we're going to talk to Chuck Slavin about me becoming the host of Regis and Kelly. Go figure that out. Also, next week, we got Tom Jarvis, who is a local author. And next week, we have got the School of Rock live here. So for all of us, including Nick Carbonelli, we will see you next time live right here on Scorch's PFG TV. Bye-bye.